This is the beginning of a morning meditation series, which the videos will be a little shorter. And the idea is to lead up to December 21st, 2012. Now let us put that date in context right here. It was on August 13th, 1999. I was lying in bed in a very relaxed mode, awake, but my consciousness had dropped away from the outside world. And then suddenly, I felt some kind of shift in my perception, and it was as if I was able to see an entire other dimension. And I was aware that this is not this world, or we're not used to. This is another dimension. And I was looking, as if hovering in the air, looking at this world and dimension and how people function there. And it was actually what I call gadget land. Everybody there, the culture, the civilization, was obsessed with gadgets. Absolutely obsessed. I couldn't believe it. Their whole consciousness was wrapped up in gadgets, and gadgetry, and using gadgets and gadgetry for everything they could possibly think of. And then I was informed through some sort of transfer of information. I was told that the world cycle that we had been going through has come to an end on August 13th, 1999, and that this people from gadget land, from this dimension, are now, they've been able to break down the dimensional barriers, as it were, between their dimension and ours, and they're flooding into this dimension here, and they're going to bring with them, they're bringing with them all their gadgetry, all their knowledge about gadgets, and they are going to rapidly, from this point forward, rapidly transform the world into something very different and very much akin to what they're used to. And I, as I continued to watch this dimension, my spirit became as if it was going to die. I felt I was going to literally die. It was horrible, like soulless, no spirit there at all, no awareness of spirit. It was just awful. And I had to pull back. I said, I can't take it anymore. I'm going to die. And I really felt it was horrible, absolutely horrible. But then afterwards, I did research on this, and I found out that the Aztec calendar actually says that this cycle that we've been going through ends on that exact date. I didn't know that at the time, August 13th, 1999. It was perfect correlation with that, so it's very accurate on the part of the Aztec calendar. So I've said in other videos that the world cycle has already ended. Already ended. Now, when a cycle ends and a new cycle begins, there's an overlap. There's an overlap. It's not abruptly like we think one ends and then there's just another starts. It's an overlap. So the last, what has it been, about 13 years has been this time of overlapping. And it was very accurate when they said that you would see an enormous expansion from this point forward of the technology into ways that we could hardly imagine. And now 2012, December 21st, that is when the new cycle. Here's an analogy. You plant a seed, it's germinates underground, it sends down the roots. And when the roots get strong enough and there's a push to root itself in the ground, and then there's a push upwards of the plant ceiling, at some point it breaks through the dirt, the soil, and goes above the soil and spreads out its leaves and begins to grow like that. The last 13 years have been a time when the seed is germinating and the sprout is heading towards the surface, and December 21st, 2012 is when the seed breaks the surface and spreads its leaves and starts a new cycle. It's like that. And the old cycle is going to be really very much kaput in a lot of ways. It's a whole different story. So we are rapidly approaching that day, very rapidly approaching. Now some expect some sort of really profound spiritual experience or something. It's possible, because I had that incredible experience on the end of the cycle, the world cycle, on August 13th, 1999. It was incredibly profound. I wasn't even expecting it. It just happened, boom, like that. So we could very well have something very significant happen on this date. That's why we're aiming to prepare for it in the best way that we can. Now, if we look back at 1999 and ask ourselves, you know, was this what I was told, was it true? And if you look back, you realize that in 1999, of course, the internet technology had been growing, putting down roots, okay? And then the roots really started growing profoundly in that year. And we had the e-trading. E-trading started that year, which has become just absolutely massive and super important, right? Electronic trading, e-trading. Also, online banking took place that year. Again, another absolutely crucial cornerstone of the new cycle. We also had MP3s were introduced, which, of course, there's been an enormous expansion of music all around the world to MP3 players and all these services. It's been another cornerstone. Also in development that year was internet phones with mobile phones with connectivity to the internet, which has become supplanting the computers. That all happened in 1999, and then the year 2000 we had wireless was introduced. So you take all those together as a nucleus for what's happening now: e-trade, online banking, MP3s, internet phones, smartphones, internet phones, and wireless. Take all of those together, and you have this nucleus that happened right then. And then that has led to this enormous push, which will enable the new cycle to officially kick off. And that's coming up very, very soon. So I'm advocating preparation for that, spiritual preparation and preparation in all ways that you feel you need to take, so you're unencumbered, and you have the capacity to focus in on these times. Now, some say that there are various various events that take place around prophesized dates that kind of tip the balance, and maybe some of these are done intentionally. That is possible. There will be something coinciding with this date, maybe brought about intentionally because people's expectations are such that the event will take place, and it will then compel and impel the world into this new cycle. And this date is fluid. It's not set in stone, but we're coming into this period now where the overlap is going to be over with. And you can feel it because basically there will be just a collective realization of the planet that we're in the new cycle with all this electronic technology. This is the way that civilization is, and there's no going back whatsoever. Now, for those who don't like this, and I count myself among them, there's no desire to go into this new cycle whatsoever, none. And that doesn't mean I'm all despondent and et cetera. No, I'm aiming to get free of all cycles, get free of existence. It's a great time. If you're able to look at the future, see what it's going to be like, and you say, I don't want any part of that. Don't want any part of it. Then that really catalyzes an inner awakening, saying, wait a minute. What are my options? So the last 13 years, for me it's actually 15 years because I was shown the future 15 years ago in 1997, not specifically to the technology, but a bigger picture of cycles, etc. Been all out emergency to say, hey, what are my options? It's all about knowing your options. And so all this new cycle, which has been brought in, been seeded and watered and fertilized and being raised up by those who came from this other dimension called Gadget Land, where we're obsessed with gadgets. You wonder, how did all this stuff come here? Because the souls incarnated from who had previously lived in Gadget Land, their consciousness incarnated on this planet. And they carried with them all the knowledge of the stuff, because to them, they had complete familiarity with all the stuff. So they saw all these things. They brought it, you know, manufactured, and it's like a piece of cake for them. They understand machine language, programming language, all the stuff. For me, I haven't a clue about any of it. I couldn't program a single line. I have zero interest in any machine language, none whatsoever. I have zero interest in robots. zero interest in really in machines or machinery or how machines work or how technology works or any of that stuff. No interest whatsoever. Now, I use it simply to convey clarity, which is appropriate use of it. But as far as is actual interest in developing it with living in a culture like, no interest. Just not my cup of tea at all. As I said, when I saw this gadget land, it was as if my spirit was going to die. It was so terrible. I felt it was lacking any depth, lacking spirit, lacking wisdom, extremely deficient. It was horrible. Just horrible. And that is where this culture is really literally going. So I am definitely very bearish on the new cycle. In other words, saying that I don't see that it's a positive thing at all. In fact, it's a severe regression is the way I see it. Severe regression. So what I'm saying is that when a new cycle commences, there is a collective shift in consciousness on a planet, which I say goes into a severe denial of an alternative option to that cycle. They go into a severe denial, and basically they say there is no other option. We're doing this because this is the way that we must do it. It's a fait accompli because there isn't any other option. That is what is worrisome to me. That is what I'm trying to convey here, and I believe I am conveying it to those who have the ears to hear it, that there will be a tremendous pressure to drop any awareness of another option at that point. Because the globe will collectively decide this is our new world, our civilization, our new cycle, and this is, therefore, we have to commit to it and go full blast ahead, because it's very important to, when that gets going, when it's just a baby, to really, really give it a big push. So they will give a huge push to this new cycle. Huge push, and that's coming up with less than a month probably, and it'll start, that big push will start. Will start, and it will just be like a tsunami of pressure. How do we stand up to those who don't want to go into that cycle, who want to be aware there's an option, and there is an option to opt out of that, opt out of existence, actually opt out of all cycles. I've seen it very clearly how the way to do it is crystal clear to me. But the pressure will be on us at that time to deny this and to say there is no option. This is simply the will of God, the fate of the universe, just how things go. This is the natural development. It's inexorable, inescapable, etc., 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 like that. It'll just be enormous pressure, from worldwide pressure, from every single angle. And I believe in the Bible it says that during this time, even the elect will be in danger of falling away from truth, meaning the pressure will be so severe that even those who have elected to opt out of this cycle and all cycles will be in danger of actually opting into it and deciding, wow, there's no option, and denying the option of choosing a new idea. They will deny it. So this is why I'm so intent and intense at this time, and have been for quite some time, 15 years, but building more and more and going public with all this. It is to alert you to this. I'm like a watchdog, bark, 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 alerting you to this situation that's coming up. And the pressure will be beyond what we realize. Beyond what we realize, because deep within us we'll feel like, uh-oh, if I am to function within this new cycle, I will have to commit and go all in with it. Otherwise, I'm not going to be able to function well. And you have this new medical laws going into effect, I believe, what is it? Is it January of 2013 or sometime in 2013, which is a game changer. It is a severe game changer. Demanding that everybody carry health insurance is just an amazing change. It's radical, radical change in our health, which beyond what we can even hardly imagine right now. This is just the very beginning, the tip of the iceberg of an entirely new culture, a new civilization, a new way of looking, and even you can call it a new dimension. It's as if the world's going into a new dimension, like a fourth dimension or something like that. But again, there are those who have had experienced awakening, true awakening, and they realize that all this is just nonsense. It's a regression, actually. It is a side trip. It is a massive delay. In terms of awakening, a massive delay, and we don't want to do it. We don't want to delay. So no way, and yet we are in harm's way in terms of pressure. So those who say, well, the world is going to end on the 21st or something, I haven't seen that. what I say is a new cycle is going to, the pressure, the commitment is going to click. There's going to be a turnkey of commitment, most likely. And the sort of the collective consciousness of the planet will decide this is the new paradigm. And it will crystallize. You know, sometimes liquids or whatever that can crystallize, that they reach a certain temperature and they're still non-crystallized, and they reach a temperature and suddenly, boom, they crystallize like that. That is how nature works. It is how this dream of existence works. And so consciousness also crystallizes. And when it crystallizes, whoa, that's a whole different ballgame then. So I am absolutely pushing here. I know the videos run a little long for you, but it's because it is so important right now at this time to dig deep and to solidify your intent, to understand the level of consent, to understand what consent is, and how you don't have to consent to this pressure, and you can consent to accepting reality as it is. As I call it, the true path of awakening is to decide that you're willing to accept reality as it is, instead of struggling to fix some problems that you think will occur to reality, which will actually never occur, which is what all these cycles are dealing with. They're dealing with challenges and problems, all stemming from an imagined hypothetical problem that we feel that we feel that reality, when at some point we'll have this problem, and so we're trying to solve it ahead of time, which is really the annihilation of reality. We're trying to solve this ahead of time by what we're doing here. And this cycle is just another attempt to solve this problem ahead of time. And it requires just an incredible submission to the machine, really. An incredible submission to technology and roboticism and biotech. And it goes on and on and on and on and on. An incredible loss of will, denial of your will, denial of the power of consent, denial of reality, denial. It requires a tremendous denial of that. So when I saw that other dimension, Gadgetland, I felt this enormous denial of reality and truth, just intense. And that's why I felt like I was like being cut off from reality. The denial was so strong, it affected me horribly. So you will see in this world, the consciousness of this planet will change, will crystallize into this severe denial of spirit, of reality, of truth, of freedom, of invulnerability, of bliss, of accepting reality as it is. All of that will be drastically denied. So I am very concerned about this time coming up, for everybody, for myself included. I don't feel I'm out of harm's way at all at this point. So I'm still full on trying to get into a situation where I'm out of harm's way, out of meaning, not somehow shielded from that pressure that is going to come in this world. So I hope this is clearing up the whole 2012 December 21st situation and the end of the world talk and all this stuff. I hope this has been a very clear exposition of what's going on. And now you can stop watching at this point if you like. I'll give you a brief chance to do that, because it's about 18 minutes, okay? And then I can go on from this point and see what arises. It's just a more of a jam session type of thing. So we can take a moment right here to gather our thoughts.